breaking news this morning. A grandfather has died and dozens more have been injured in a terrifying mid-air emergency. A Singapore Airlines flight with 56 Australians on board hit severe turbulence on its way to Singapore from London, forcing it to make an emergency landing in Bangkok. Home Affairs Minister Claire O'Neill has just confirmed 8 of the Aussies were injured. CNN aviation expert and friend of Sunrise, Richard Quest, joins us now. Good morning, Richard. How can this happen? They're flying along, suddenly so many people are injured.
Good question. First of all, the SQ321 will be a flight known to many Australians who do the kangaroo route. It is one of those, if you will, touchstone flights. So here's your plane. This is a 777-200, same sort. And it's going along, all right? But then there's bad weather ahead. Over Myanmar, there is this storm sequence. And for whatever reason, either pilots ahead or air traffic control, no one really tells them about it. And they start to do this. But what's fascinating about this now is if you look at the numbers, and this is the yellow column, the numbers show that the plane only went up and down by several hundred feet a time. It would go up 100, down 200, up 50, down 75. But the velocity of the plane, the force with which it was doing, was so intense. So we see this plane suddenly going up by 900 feet a minute and dropping by 1,100 feet a minute, up by 500 a minute, down by 200 a minute. And it's these smallish movements, but with tremendous force, that creates the damage and destruction that you see. Because on board the aircraft, they were just getting ready to serve breakfast before the plane was, say, an hour or two out of Singapore.
We have seen pictures from inside that plane, and the baggage bins are broken in some situations. That takes force. For someone to fly up into the air, we would presume, and break it. Why would that have happened? Right. Because would that be because people didn't have their seatbelts on?
Right. Let me just find something I can use as a prop here. Right. Imagine this is one of the people. All right. Just a makeup puff. Imagine this is one of the people. But the plane's flying along, and suddenly it drops. The roof is here, and they hit. Right. And that's what happens. That's exactly what happens to people on the plane. Think of an egg in a bottle. If you shake the bottle, the egg's going to break. And that's what happened. Now, add into that the moment, I mean, these, by the way, the bins are designed so they won't completely collapse. But the ceiling panels, they're designed to be taken off and put back on again. Mm. So when you get some forces, they'll break open, bits will fall off, ventilation, nothing significant. All the significant stuff is under the floor. Mm. So that was never in any risk. And the plane itself, Nat, I know people are worried about this. The plane itself was never in any danger. The plane is built to withstand far more of forces. The problem is you and I are not, and we become the proverbial egg in the bottle when the plane hits turbulence.
Is this a reminder for all of us who probably think, oh, well, I've just come back from the bathroom, I won't put my seatbelt on, or I'm lying down, I won't put my seatbelt on, although they warn us to put our seatbelt on?
Oh, yes. I mean, let me ask you just a blunt question. What sort of idiot would sit in a metal tube that's bouncing through the air at 500 or 600 miles an hour in unpredictable circumstances without being tied down? Because that's essentially, if I put those facts to you, that's essentially what we're talking about.
Well, all of us blasé at some point.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. It's blasé. I did it today flying back from London to New York. Yeah. I thought, I'm not going to bother to do that.
We've all done it. Exactly. Or you get up to go to the bathroom and then you're just roaming free. Sometimes it just happens. Yes. Sorry.
When you walk to the bathroom, put your hand up so you're balanced against the overhead compartments.
Okay.
But look, I'm not going to preach and lecture because I'm as guilty as you are.
We all are. Thank you, Richard. We appreciate your very descriptive description. Thank you. Here's Sherbo.